The next is basically for you to provide improvement for the website. You need to do this with the web developer. So basically the first thing is to, let me list them out for you. Ideas for website improvement. Number one, use white space. So let's go to my website. As you can see, these are basically white space. So use white space for the website so the text will be visible. Number two, optimize your page speed. The website should be able to load at around 1 to 3 seconds. For this, I'm not going to show you this. I'll show you when I get to this part. I'll show you when I get to this part of the technical SEO. How to go about this. The next is use attractive call to action. I don't have call to action on my website, so let us go to other websites call to action. Let's go to DHL. So this is a call to action. As you can see, if you open on it, it changes colors. Can you see it changes colors? So this is, let's go to another one. Let's go to UPS. I think they should have a button. The call to action is basically what you want the user to do when they get to your website. What you want the website visitors to do when you get to your website. That button. So this is a button sign. As you can see, it's changing color and then another line. Color. So this is what you should be able to achieve. So it's changing color on the line. So let's go back to what we were doing. The next is use hyper link differentiation. So what does this mean? This means simply means that like this is my website. The hyperlink is different, the color is different from the text and it's bold. And apart from that, on several websites, let's say this is an hyperlink. This is not doing anything, but some websites it does, as you can see. So an hyperlink is a clickable text. If we go to that of a DHL, I believe it's still like that. But these are international websites and we expect to get the best. These are all hyperlink items. It's changing color. So these are all international websites. It's changing color. It's an hyperlink. Any hyperlink is a clickable text. So this is the differentiation. The next is a segment key information with bullet point. So what are bullets? What are basically key information? These are key information sheet. These are bullet points, an icon. You place it with an icon. As you can see, then fewer text. So the next use image wisely. So use fewer image. Use image. Don't overpopulate the text. With use image wisely. Don't overpopulate the text. The website with a lot of images, not good. 7. Include well designed and written headlines. So let's check on my blog. These are headlines. These are headlines. The font is different. There should be headlines here, so these are basically headlines. So let's move on. Keep your website pages consistent. So basically you update your website. Then I check for broken link. That's the next. That is where you have catch your for. So check for broken links, check, work on them. You either delete them or recreate the content or delete them. No, you either recreate the content, redirect users to the home page, or delete the link. So these are the, I think for my own end, I believe that is the best way to go about it. Either you recreate the content, either you redirect the users to the home page, or you delete the link. I believe delete the link should be the last option, because at the end you drive somebody to your website. At the end you want to keep the person. You don't want them to lose. So once they get to the home page, they will want to find their way through the website, and clicking on other links helps towards decrease your bounce rate and increase your rating. So next is the last but not least, best responsive. I'll just go with be responsive, or make your website responsive. Responsive and mobile friendly. I'll teach you how to make your website responsive and mobile friendly, in the sense that whenever you open your website, let me show you something from my website. This is my website. The responsiveness for your website to be able to fit the screen of any screen resolution, and in a way that the text and everything would not be distorted, it will still be the same thing. So let me show you something. Let's inspect this website. Okay, let us go to page source. No, this is not what I want. I want you to get inspect. Inspect, yeah. So this is the website. This is where you check for responsiveness. Let's go. So this is what. This is the dimension. Let's go for different kind of phones. And so this iPhone SE. Make responsive. This is a Galaxy X8. Go back. The home page. This is a Galaxy Fold. This is so there are a lot of them. This is Pixel 7. But basically, this is not the right way to check if your website is web friendly. But this is still something. I'm going to do that when we go to the part of mobile friendly test. So we're done. Thank you for watching. Once you're done with this, you just put yes. You pick the information, so you can just simply write, use this to improve the website. copy, because you'll be sending this to the owner of the website. You put it here, be aligned, and you put little bit of media. So this is it. So this is how you do provide information for website improvement. Thank you all for watching.